Hello folks, welcome back. In today's video, I will show you how to calculate difference between two dates in Power Automate workflows. So stay tuned and let's jump into the demo after this short intro. I'm on a SharePoint training site. I have an expenses list here. So the list have a column created. So when this expense was actually submitted. So you can see the two entries there. One is 17th of August this year. Next one is 3 minutes ago, which means recently created. So what I want is I want to create a Power Automate workflow, which will take the today's date minus whenever the expense was created and calculate the difference. So I'm expecting this to be returned zero, which means that it is only created today. So there is no date difference. And this I'm expecting around 24 days difference. So to create this workflow, I need to go to office.com. By the way, today dates is 11th of September. That's why I said 17th of August and 11th of September will be around 24 days difference. So if I go to office.com and from Office 365 portal, I can click on the ellipses of the left hand corner and click on Power Automate application icon. This will take me to the Power Automate application landing page. From the left hand menu, I can click on create. Now for this demo purpose, I will just create an instant workflow which I can just trigger myself and test it. I will click instant workflow. I will give this workflow a name. I will call it calculate date diff, which is difference. Manually trigger a flow. This will create a first step for me. Next step I want is I want to go through all the records in this SharePoint list. So I will click on next step and I will search for get items action of SharePoint. I will select the site where the list exists. The training site and the list name, we know this is expenses list, and that's it. Click save. So we're done with that step. Now we got all the items, we need to then apply for each loop to navigate through each item in this list. So next step, we'll select apply to each control of Power Automate. So this will be input from the previous step, which is the value from the get item. So value list of item, and then the next action we want to get item. So we will select get item this time. The site address will be again the same site and the list will be the same expenses list. The only difference is when you provide an ID so we can retrieve an individual item from that list. So we will get the ID from this previous step. So we'll select the ID column here so we can get the ID dynamically. Now we need to calculate the date difference from today's date and minus the date when the expense was created. So let me just go back and create a variable here. So I will click on add an action. I forgot to create that in the first place. I will initialize variable. I will call this variable days since expense submitted. So how many days since the expense is submitted. The type will be integer. Now if I come back to my for each loop under this get item, I will set this variable. Add an action. I will click set variable action of Power Automate. I will select the variable which is days since expense submitted and the value. Now this is an important one to understand. Now if you see this is a bit complicated expression here, so let's take one by one. Div mean we're dividing at the end. Sub mean we are subtracting. Ticks, so one tick is 100 nanosecond unit is called a tick. Now this is we're formatting UTC now is today's date. And then we are putting in this format. That's why we're formatting it. And when we call it ticks and this today's date in formatted way, which means these are the number of ticks since 1st of Jan 1601 until today. And then when we take this next tick, this is number of ticks we're using the created by column. So number of ticks since 1st of Jan 1601 till the date it was created. And we are subtracting these two ticks. So from today's date minus date created. So we subtract these two ticks. And the next thing we need to do is whatever the number comes up, we are dividing that number by number of ticks in the whole day. So that's the number here. You can have any different columns you want from SharePoint list to have this date and this date. So for example, if I just remove this one and I will take this expression like this, I will put in the comment section below this expression so you can copy and paste in your Power Automate workflow. So if I copy this one and if I go to value and expression and if I paste this here and where I added the created column, I will select that location, go back to dynamic content, and you can select any column you wish. I will select created again. So you can see that the created by column is added. So it will calculate the difference between today's date and when that expense was created. So if I click OK, that's done. Next thing we can do is we can just send an email to see if it's calculating the difference correctly for each record. So click to add an action, send an email notification. That's the action we want. I will just send it to myself and the subject. I will put the expense and then title of the expense and I'll just say days since created. Yeah, and then in the body, I will say title, and I will select title, and then I will say days since created. We will select the variable days since expense submitted. Okay, so we are sending an email for each record in SharePoint list to see how many days it's been since the expense is created. This logic can be used in archiving some document. For example, if you have a document which are created or last modified, let's say 6 months ago or a year ago, and you want to see that if that is the case, so you can archive those documents. So I'm done with the workflow now. I will click on save. So the workflow is saved. Now I can quickly test this workflow by clicking on the test, and I will say I will perform this action and click on test, and I will click on continue to give my workflow permission to SharePoint, and then I will click on run flow and click done. Now you can see the flow ran successfully. If I navigate back to my email, I have received two emails. The first email is saying the expense title is accommodation expense and the day since created is zero, which means that I have just created a few minutes ago. That's why the day difference is zero. But if I look into the other email, this is the travel expense and the days since created is 24, which is this travel expense. It was created on 17th of August and today is 11th of September. So it's been 24 days since it's created. Just to wrap up this video, today you have learned how you can easily calculate the difference between the two dates in Power Automate using the help of expressions. Consider subscribing if you're new to the channel by pressing the red subscribe button below this video. Give this video a thumbs up if you found it useful. If you have any queries related to Power Automate or anything related to Office 365 in general, post in the comment section below. I do review my comments on a daily basis. I will be happy to answer. Thank you.